I see this question a lot with new volunteers to audio, and that is, what is phantom power? And that's totally fine to be asking this because it hasn't been taught to you yet. So phantom power is what powers an active microphone or an active DI box. Now, standard microphones, like this dynamic microphone here, which is a Shure SM57, this is a dynamic mic, and it does not require phantom power because there is no active circuitry inside of this microphone. It uses magnets and coils of wire with a diaphragm to move back and forth, and that is what creates electrical energy that travels down this microphone cable to your mixer to then be amplified into our sound that we then mix. Now, a microphone like this is a condenser microphone, and there is actually circuitry inside the body of this microphone that needs to have power. And that power is called phantom power. And that power is sent down this XLR on pins 2 and 3 and uses 1 for the ground. And it's plus 48 volts. Now, you can also have phantom power plus 24 volts, but in most cases, all the professional mixers out there are going to have a phantom power of plus 48. And that travels to this microphone to power the circuitry inside of the microphone to then create our acoustical energy into electrical energy that then goes down this XLR to your mixer to then be able to mix. Now, if you plug in this microphone and do not have phantom power turned on, it won't work. You will get zero volume out of this mic. So if you have a microphone plugged in and you're not getting any signal and you think that it requires phantom power, double check the manual, see if it's a condenser microphone, activate phantom power, and then that microphone will work. Now, one caution that I have for you is do not apply phantom power to a ribbon microphone because you will destroy the ribbon mic. So just keep that in mind. So active microphones like a condenser microphone or an active direct box do require phantom power to be turned on your mixer. So just keep that in mind.